There is a beautiful sloka, sloka from Tantra, which says, when you are comfortable with your body, every point feels like a nectar. You will be filled, your whole being, your whole form will be filled with nectar. Of course, today we are going to practice that meditation. Today we will see the meditation from that Tantra. Shiva says, if you are really loving, if you really accept your body as you are, as it is, every inch, you will feel like a nectar. You will feel as if your whole body is filled with nectar. Actually, your body is filled with nectar. Your body is filled with life energy. Otherwise, how will you be alive? How will you be alive? You are alive because your body is filled with life energy. But you never respect your life energy. You continuously go around seeing all the other person's body. You are continuously attracted towards other bodies. Because you are attracted to others' bodies, you never feel homely, comfortable with your body. With your body. I am not even talking about the relationship. I am talking about the ideal bodies. A male getting attracted to the male body. A female getting attracted to the female body. That is the thing I am talking. Continuously imagining about your ideal actor or ideal actress. My body should be like that. I should do all my makeup or bodybuilding up just like that. And this hairdressing, manicuring the nails. How much you do seeing somebody else's body, you may have the praise, you may have a few words from the others, but you will never feel homely with your body. You will never feel joy or bliss in your body. First thing you need to understand, stop hating your body and stop having the ideal body. Stop having the idea of ideal body. Then you will see your body becomes ideal for you. And have you heard of Samudriga Lakshana? That Shastra says, every mind, according to its needs, creates its own body. So, exactly your body is created by your mind as it should be. According to that Shastra, your body is created by your mind as it should be. It is never created for somebody else. If you try to create your body seeing somebody else's body, you will start living only their life. You will never be able to live your life. Understand the very first thing. Your body is created for your life, not for anybody else's life. Stop changing your body like somebody else's. Don't have any particular ideal or goal somebody else's body. Be totally relaxed, joyful and comfortable with your body. You will see, you will have total well-being of your being. Not only diseaselessness, total well-being. The first step towards love is loving your body, feeling comfortable within your body. Unless you love your body, you will not live throughout your body. Now, you don't live throughout your body. You live only in one portion. Your whole mind is thinking of somebody else's body. First, understand and accept your body as it is. Love your body. Next, love your mind. Like us, nobody condemns our own mind. Look little deep into yourself, then you will understand how much you condemn yourself. If you sit alone, nothing else will come up from your mind except guilt. However you live, how much you live the good, beautiful, joyful or peaceful life, you will have some guilt about yourself. Only through guilt, only through self-condemnation, you spoil your whole joy. And spoiling your own joy is a habit for you. You don't feel comfortable if you are joyful. You feel something is wrong. Whenever things go totally happy, whenever things go without any problem, whenever things are settled, you feel something is wrong. You feel some uneasiness. What is happening? Things are going so well. You feel some juice only when some worries are there or something is there to worry about. If you don't feel anything to worry, you feel uneasy. So you create something. I have seen the people creating guilt not only with the outer things, even with the inner things, divine things. You yourself take up some puja. And if you miss one day, then guilt. And immediately you will associate some incident along with that guilt. Because I have not done puja, this problem came. And then you start with the full swing. Some other day, some other reason, if you miss one more day, then again, guilt. Already you have enough of guilt. Now the inner world, the divine things also adds little more for your guilt. Guilt is the thing which makes you hate your mind. You have thousands of choice in front of you. Continuously you can choose anything from the world. But you choose only the things which makes you more solid. Solid means what? More sorrow, more heavy. You can choose anything. Now for example, if somebody criticizes you, you can choose anything. Either you can choose to be strong and not to bother, or you can choose to get disturbed. But be very clear, you are choosing. Don't think somebody else is choosing. When somebody criticizes you, it is not necessarily you should choose only the point that getting upset. You can use something else. You can be even strong. But what you do? You always choose to get upset, to get disturbed. It is your choice, nobody else's choice. And be very clear, all your feelings, all your emotions are just your choice. You may not be aware that you are choosing. Because of continuous conditioning, you forget whether you choose or that chooses by itself. But everything is just your choice. If you choose, you see, for example, if you choose the one road to go to your office, every day you use the same road to go to your office. Same way you reach your office. In holiday, if you want to go somewhere else also, if you choose the route, that road, you will exactly see automatically your car will go and stand in front of your office. Then suddenly you will remember, oh, today no office is there. Today no office is there, I have come here. You have chosen the road, but you have not remembered that you have chosen the road because of your habit. Same way, somebody criticizes you, immediately you choose to get upset. Because you have decided the same choice, same decision for so many times, you forget you choose. But actually you only choose. It is you who choose to get upset. you have all the full freedom, you have all the capacity to choose the other ways also. You can choose wise or to be otherwise. Either way you can choose. You can choose to get upset or you can choose to upset him. When you are criticized, you can choose to get upset or you can choose to upset him also. If you are not upset, naturally what is going to happen? He is going to get upset. It is just your choice. In front of you, everything is available. The feeling of love, feeling of acceptance, feeling of joy, feeling of guilt, feeling of self-condemnation, everything is available. But you choose only the guilt and condemnation. First thing, drop the ideal body and live in your body. Start loving your body. Next thing, drop all your self-condemnation idea. Accept yourself as you are. Accept your being as you are. Accept your mind as you are. And choose to be happy. A conscious decision not to get upset by anything outer. The third thing, loving your being. Loving your being needs a deep understanding. Why you don't accept your being? One more thing, none of us accept our being as we are. None of us accept our being as we are. We always wanted our being should be either like Bill Gates or like a this man, that man, that man, that man. Or if you can somehow avoid all those greed, then you start greedy about the Buddha. My being should become like a Buddha, like Nityananda. You see, greed happens in many forms. I became Nityananda when I stopped the idea of being somebody else. If you really want to become like Buddha, or like me, or like a master, like a totally satisfied being, first stop craving to become like some being, somebody else. The very thought to become somebody else, to become like somebody, only makes you not to accept yourself. If you understand your being, if you understand one or two things about your being, then everything will be settled. Your being is immune to criticism. And it is so simple, so innocent, it always respects the whole universe. And it never feels it is beneath somebody, but it has always got respect for the whole world, whole universe. What we do, why we don't accept our being? What actually happens in our system? You do two things. First thing, you try to project which you are not. Either you try to project which you are not, or you try to cover which you are. That is why you hate your being. Either you try to project which you are not, or you try to cover which you are. If you look around your life, 90% of your energy is spent only to project what you are not. It's how it is like, you know, you are only 6 feet height, but you have somehow made 12 feet cutout. Wherever you go, just you carry the cutout in front of you. Wherever you go, you just carry the cutout in front of you. 90% of your energy is just spent only carrying that cutout. That cutout is more strong, more wealthy, more rich, more beautiful cutout. You make what all you don't have, but you want to have, you put the whole thing and make a diagram, make a cutout and carry in front of you. what all you want to have but you don't have. You put everything and make an image. Sometimes not even a cutout, you make a big idol, statue, and wherever you go, you just carry that statue. 90% of your energy is spent just to prove, just to show, just to project what you are not. 2 things. If you drop doing that, 2 things will happen to you. When you start loving yourself, 2 things can happen to you. First thing, 90% of your energy, which is getting wasted to project what you are not, the 90% of energy will be consumed, will be useful for you. It will not be wasted. The next thing, you can really understand and appreciate what you are. You can really understand and appreciate what you are. Because every being is unique. Understand about your being. Just few words. You are immune to criticism. Your being is totally innocent, simple, unique. You are never beneath somebody, but you are totally innocent and humble. Everyone's being knows that all others are also beings. All others are also beings. When you understand your being, you neither project yourself too high and get criticized, get depressed, or you go for criticizing others. You totally understand and live joyfully, ecstatically with your being. When you love your body, from beauty you enter into grace. If you don't love your body, how much makeup you do, you know how long it is going to stand. It's never going to stand. Beauty and grace is totally different. When you love your body, you have the new grace. When you love your mind, you enter into a space of total satisfaction. When you love your being, you enter into the space of bliss and love. If you can love your body, mind and being, the love can become door to the divine. The love can lead you to the divine. Because when your body, mind and love, when your body, mind and being, when all these three is integrated, you become whole. Whenever you are whole, you are holy. Wholeness and holiness is one and the same. When you are cut to pieces, only then you are man. When you are integrated, you are simply being. Being means God, life and love. When your being is integrated, when you love your body, mind and the being, you totally enter into a different realm where you experience you are divine, you are God. The poison which is inside your being is just removed. What I say, poison, the gap between yourself to yourself. You have so many gaps in yourself. Those gaps only I call it as a poison. When those gaps are healed, whenever you start loving your body, body gets healed. Whenever you start loving your mind, mind gets healed. Whenever you start loving your being gets healed. When all these three layers are healed, you are enlightened. A man who is totally healed, a man who is totally within himself, a man who is totally healed only can become a healer. Man who is healed, he only can become a healer. Man who is totally healed can become divine. A man who is totally healed is divine. So love not only acts as a door to divine, love simply makes you divine. So let you understand this ultimate love and enter into divine. Let your being enter into the divine. Let you become Nitya Ananda. Thank you.